He is live at the New York Stock Exchange. Simon, good morning.
Thank you, Willie. Good morning. Yeah, we're looking at a slightly higher open here. I mean, things are much quieter than they were last week. Overnight, we've had some good results coming out from the retailers. Target, Staples, Abercrombie are all likely to rise at the open. There was a bit of a disappointment with Dell, particularly on its revenue, and they were talking about their business starting to slow down in the middle of June, and that slowdown continued through its quarter. Now, that's a concern, obviously, because we're all trying to second guess what sort of growth we're going to get in the second half of the year. At the moment, although Dell will come under some pressure, no doubt, at the open as it did in after-hours trade last night, it seems to be the view that this may be a Dell-specific phenomenon or a tech phenomenon. And we've got Hewlett-Packard, of course, reporting later in the week as well. So we're kind of on tenterhooks at the moment. Of course, we got the Merkel-Sarkozy meeting yesterday, which was a damp squib as far as the optimists were concerned, the bulls were concerned. They didn't say that they'd increase the size of the rescue fund, and they certainly weren't talking about establishing euro bonds to share the risk, the burden within Europe anytime soon. And in fact, Europe traded down in the wake of that this morning, partly because it's going to be a new financial transaction tax, though Europe is coming back to the flat line as we look at this higher open here at the New York Stock Exchange, Willie.
Simon, you mentioned yesterday Germany last quarter only 0.1% growth,
yes,
GDP. At what point did Germans say, we're getting dragged down by the rest of Europe, we don't want any part of the eurozone, we don't want any part of these bailouts?
Well, as I mentioned to you yesterday, there is if you look at the opinion polls, there is a growing feeling that that is an issue within Germany. But it's not. I mean, if you say to people, are you really unhappy with the status quo? Oftentimes they'll say yes. The problem is dismantling the euro. Were that, I mean, there is no mechanism to do that. So to go through that process would be so chaotic and so difficult. And perhaps as Angela Merkel keeps reminding the Germans, a lot of their success at the moment is based on the euro. It's based in the fact that they're effectively within a single currency that is far lower than if they were in the Deutschmark, which would have rocketed like the Swiss franc, and their exports would be hit to a greater extent. But clearly, it is the unpopularity of the situation is swelling, not just in Germany, Willie, it has to be said.
Pat Buchanan's got a question.
Simon, it seems that you've either got to go forward to sort of a federal union of Europe toward the United States of Europe, or you've got to go back basically to the old free trade zone idea, and they seem to be caught and unable to decide. Is that right?
Yes, I think that is probably true, because they've reached a point at which the Germans are going to have to start giving up, for example, big things. They're going to have to start sharing their good credit name if they do this euro bonds type issue. But on the other side of it, if you look at what Merkel and Sarkozy were saying yesterday, they are talking about greater fiscal consolidation. They are saying to the rest of Europe, okay, we've reached a point now where you need balanced budget amendments in your constitutions by next summer. We're going to start coordinating to a greater extent. But Mr. Buchanan, and if you remember, that's the sort of stuff, bar the balanced budget amendments, they were saying right at the beginning under the Maastricht Treaty. Mm-hmm. It's just they never enforced it. They never had discipline. But there is at least talk of that.
All right. Simon Hobbs live for us at the New York Stock Exchange. Thanks so much, Simon. Okay. We'll talk to you soon.
Have a good day.